Just wanted to give a little tutorial on doing a histogram. I just learned. In fact, I just learned this. Okay, first you need, of course, data, which I have the data of volleyball. Aces versus points. So what you want to do is, if you haven't already, go to File Options and then Add-ins, and then you should see the Analysis Tool Pack, and then make sure that Manage is Excel Add-ins, then press Go, and it should be able to activate the Analysis Tool Pack, which you will need to make a histogram in Microsoft Excel 2007 and 2010, and I believe also 2013. So after that, then press OK, then you have what you need. So next thing to do, after you have, of course, your data, you're going to need to go to Data here, right here, and then Data Analysis. Click on Data Analysis. This will show up, and then click Histogram. So you're going to need to put the input range. So the input range is basically the actual data. So let's do the points scored for this. So the input range is going to be C2 colon C8, which is right from here down to here. So the next part is the bin range. Click on labels. And so next part is the bin range. Now the bin range is basically some what you'll need to add an extra column for. So let's just do that. Just for the bin. We're gonna actually just fill in what is the range we're looking for. So 0, let's do 5, 10, no, 0, 5, 10, and 15. Let's do that. Or you can do 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 if you want. So let's go back to the data analysis. Histogram. Input range is C2 colon C8. C2 colon, and you may actually want to do the dollar sign. The dollar sign means it's an absolute. The dollar sign basically means it's an absolute cell number. So you probably want to do that. So the bin range is from absolute E to colon absolute E9. And then click on labels, and then output just new worksheet. So let's see what it does. Contains an error. Okay, so we're gonna do it just regular, just the relative E2 to E9. So in this arbitrary example, okay, so the something like this happens for some reason. So let's insert shift cells entire row. So we're going to frequency 2. So you may have to You may have to manually put the numbers in. So you're gonna have to know the frequency. So there's 1, 2. So 1, no zeros, 1, 2, 4. And in this case, no fours. 6, no sixes either. 8 is 2, 3. 10 is 0. 12 is 1. And 14 is 2. So now we've got that. So then you do a regular scatter plot. This is what comes up if you have to do it manually, but let's say we're going to do 0, 5, 10, 15. So we're gonna do the whole thing again. Data analysis, histogram, C2 to C8, E1 to E5. Okay. Then do a scatter plot. Okay. Regular scatter plot to see what we've got. Okay, hope this kind of helps you a little bit. Let's try this, A2 to A. Actually, it's the other way around. Alright, let me just so actually let's go to histogram. Here we go. We put the input range of C something and E2 to just do a scatter plot. Alright. this case we'll probably need it. That's better. And then just do a scatter plot. Done. So that's how you do it. See, so for the bin range, you're gonna need to make sure that you put an appropriate bin size. So let's do one more, and we're going to do data analysis, histogram, and from C1 to C8, and then E1 to E9, labels, and then just do a scatter plot. You've got it. That's exactly how to do it. Thank you. Have a good day.